pen first. Where is the pen? Just the pen.
Pen. So the pen.
Yes.
Okay, so the case reasoning is a non-new one, huh? But until now, still many research, is based on case reasoning, because case reasoning also is the extension of our experiments. So they set all your experiments on the data set. When you face another question that he can retrieve from the data set to find any previous question, we have solved it. And we use this method to solve it. That is the test-based reasoning. The test-based reasoning. So, we also introduce this because the case-based reasoning can combine with many AI technology. But dual case-based reasoning is not easy one because the system may be need to store many knowledge inside. So the outline of the case-based reasoning we will introduce is about the sometimes we use the idea of the nearest neighborhood, which one is more similar. So we have need to have a methodology and the detailed method to find which one is the nearest neighbor. And test-based reasoning also can combine with the fuzzy we said previous. And so we introduce this test-based reasoning is a relative new outcome to AI. But now it's a new one because this is a very traditional. Definition of the test-based reasoning. CBR is test-based reasoning. That means a test reasoner solve the problem by using or adapting solution to all problems. That means use all problem to make it to current problem. When we learn it, we also based on this experience. I think this method can combine with the inference reasoning on some research. Because case-based reasoning is based on your previous knowledge. Previous knowledge. Like a search tree, we said the taboo search. A taboo search, he has some area is restricted. You don't touch this area because go to this area is dangerous. You cannot find a solution. You just waste a time. Test-based reasoning also similar. He don't plan to search. Just only search the similar test. So what is this methodology? This methodology, the Peter Chapman, he said, and organize a set of principles which guide action in typing to manage real-world problem situation. Case-based circle fits nicely to the definition of methodology, set of principles. Which guide action. So here we can find this is the structure of the case-based reasoning. So the step is the first one here is to the retriever, retriever. And then he go to the data case space, case space to retrieve the similar case. If you can retrieve, then this case can be reused to solve your problem and propose solution to you. But when you retrieve the problem, but he cannot solve your problem, you need to revise, revise the case. Revise the case means we'll generate a new case. So if we'll generate a new case, and then this new case will add to the case base data set. That is retrain or retrain. And then you can get the confirmed solution. You can find this structure is based on our learning experiments. When we face a dangerous situation, what do? You retrieve your mind or your brain information, brain knowledge or your knowledge. Then use the current knowledge to solve the problem. If you try but cannot solve, you need to modify. And then after this, you have modified. You have this experiments. So the experiments will rely to your knowledge system. So sometimes we say we learning from mistake. That is like this. People learning from this mistake. And then they can enhance their experiments of the life. So besides, we can add some technology of computer science here. For example, how to retrieve the similar case. You can use the statistics method. You can use neural network. You can use fuzzy logic. You can use dual system or the database or the algorithm of the nearest the neighborhood. Then use some technology to retrieve. And how do you do the revise? The revise, you can use the genetic algorithm and other some function program or dual system to finish. And then this is maybe a relational database or object database. It now can be the big data, that can be on the Hadoop system. Now that means the experiment. So now new AI here, maybe the unstructured data, structured data or semi-structured data here, can be extend the idea of test-based reason. So he is retriever the similar test to the problem described. Reuse solutions suggest by similar case and revise or adapt that solution to be better fit the new problem. And the case-based reasoning, how to use the neighborhood, Here is a function, I think. Then I hope I can drive. is our virgin cannot use pen.
Cannot.
PDF cannot. Okay. Then here, here we can find this area. This area we can find that is T-I-N-S-I. That means here is the target and one is your source text. Source text means that is in the case database. Case database. Target means your current problem. You face current problem. And each target have I means the attribute. So means your problem you can organize by many attributes. And then for the function here, here is to calculate the distance of the feature, of the target feature with the source feature. But maybe each feature, the importance is different. So we give them a weight. The weight is WI. If you have no weight, every attribute is the same. Then WI can be the one. So means I don't care. But if we have a different important feature for different attribute, then you can set weight. So the case-based reasoning also can induction arguments like the ID3. ID3 is a decision tree. Next week, we have a remodeling. We also introduce about the decision tree, how the calculation, identify pattern along test and partition the test to clustering. So here, use the clustering technology. For example, your test space have 10,000 tests here, but you want to retrieve. How to retrieve? Maybe you in your data set, you can use some algorithm to clustering to different parts. And then he just only mapping belong to which part, and then just search on that clustering area. That is the technology. Assume that case with a similar problem. This point we are referring to similar problem, and hence have similar solutions. So case-based reasoning also can combine with fuzzy. How to combine? Because test-based reasoning here, he used the attribute to completion. And then each attribute, you can define the membership function. Use the fuzzy mapping or fuzzy compare to find the difference. So the fuzzy, you can define the fuzzy membership function like here, that to do the attribute matching, usually in attribute matching. And they also use the database acknowledge, technology. And they also can use the some big data technology, So you can use like the SQL to combine to the case-based implement. So we now give an example to find how the case-based reasoning operation. This is a question. Not technical analysis of the car first, and the symptom we have find or an observer, and the value and have measure. For example, that is a battery voltage is 6.3 voltage. An engine doesn't start. We observe this situation. And the goal is to find the cost for the fare and a repair strategy. So our goal is to repair and find what the problem. Then we use the test phase to do the diagnosis. A test describes a diagnosis situation and content. And we need to describe the symptom, define the fare and cost, or describe description of repair strategy. And finally, we store a collection of tests in the test space. Find tests similar to the current problem, and we use repair strategy. So we do this test. This is already in the test space. Test space and test like this. This one is the problem. Problem. The fun light doesn't work. This is the question. And the car is the Volkswagen Golf 2, 1.6, and year is 1993, and battery, and the status of light, or status of the light switch, and maybe have many items. So each one of this, you can see that is like attribute. So you can reference them as attribute. And the solution is diagnosis. Diagnosis from light fuse defect. Because it's from light doesn't work. So we want to diagnose this question. And our repair, in this case, our repair on data set is set replace from light fuse, replace from light fuse. Just only do the work, and we can repair the car. And another case, previous is test one. We have a test two. Test two is the front light doesn't work also. And the car is audio, different brand, audio A6. That the year is 1995. Battery and state of light, state of light switch. And diagnosis is ground defect, ground defect. That we replace the We replace the front light, maybe change the tube, and finish. Now we have a new problem, must be solved. We make several observations in current situation. Observation define a new problem. Not all feature value must be known. So here, our new problem is like this. This problem is gray light doesn't work. Our two case is front light doesn't work. And then this car brand is audio 18. Year and battery, voltage and state of light. This is a question we want to solve it. But how we to do? We need to compare the new problem with the case. Now try to find when two tests similar or not. Because we have many similar tests in the data set, but how to rank? We need to rank which one is more suitable test to retrieve. So we need to have some policy, some methodology to do the comparison. Here is one of the technology to do the compare. For example, the feature problem. The front light doesn't work. Gray light doesn't work. That have the similar. That this is all 0.8. If the engine doesn't start, that is all point.
So how do you come up with this 0.8 and 0.4?
0.4?
Yeah.
How the value?
Yes.
The value, one technology is to use the wall comparison. For example, this wall with this wall is different. But the light doesn't work. So they have four walls, but one wall is different. So at this time, the engineer need to design the method how to compare. But this is a good method, that may be not. So based on your logic, you just think which policy is legal. Is logically, you can explain. So, for example, this one, only one word matching, doesn't, and two words. But how the value of the matching with the value? That may be a membership function, may be just a mathematical function to find the value. Okay. And then, here, we have another feature comparison. Above is the water, or maybe the test comparison. But the next one is battery voltage comparison. But this comparison, we can find here is 3.6. Here is 12.6. This is the test. The test is the 12.6 or 12.6, and another test one is 12.9, and the test is 30.6. So you can compare it. This is the example of the comparison, but maybe why the comparison here is 0.9, because usually the higher score, that is the similar is higher, lower score the similar is lower, but 0.9 how to find it, you just can make some mathematics, maybe you use distance, and after the distance you normalize or something, just to get the value. So in this situation, a new case will compare with the older case and compare every attribute. So you can assign which attribute is more important. So assign a different way on the system. So for example, he said very important will be get the 6. Very important. And less important is get the weight is 1. So you compare this test with this. For example, assume the relation value is this. So based on the similar test, because totally the weight, the weight may be how three feature is 6, and two feature is 1, so totally weight is 20. In order to normalize, so we divide by 20. That means all the weight is normalized to summation is 1. Summation is 1. So you can get the value of 0.8 multiplied 6, 0.4 multiplied 1, and so on, you get a score. If we can get a score, we can ranking. So we can ranking the course. And another case, after computation, we get the different score. And then we just select the case with highest score, with the highest score. And then because this case, Dynasys is a Fondite fuse defect, and repair is a Fondite fuse. But this test just only similar, not fully accept the same. So we need to do adaption. Our adaption is replaced with the Fondite, with Fredite, because our question just only this wall is different. So we replace the wall. So the Fredite fuse defect, replace Fredite fuse. So this is the case-based reasoning methodology. Okay, have any question about the case-based? So case have many attributes. Many attributes we can define the weight for different attributes. And we need to have a method to calculate the distance between the attributes. In here, you can apply many computer technology inside. You can do the clustering. You can do the fuzzy, even genetic algorithm to find the weight of the parameter. Genetic algorithm usually used on the parameter selection. So the weight you can let the genetic algorithm do the training. Okay. So now we have a new case. This case previous is not existed in the data set. So the new case, we have a previous, we have two cases. Then we add a new case to the data set. But this new case need to pull by expert, maybe pull by human, not really solve the question. We can use, and in the future, if have the same question, we can use this method to solve it. So we make a conclusion on the test-based reason. So view test-based reasoning as a methodology. It's important to its continued development. So until now, we can still use the test-based reasoning. If you do the research of the test-based reasoning, this kind of the paper usually easy to accept. But this kind of the paper will waste a lot of time to implement, usually because you need to collect many tests. So sometimes maybe you have a data set, already have many cases, but you can apply this method to do this research, to evaluate, to put your selection method is better than ever. And it became clear that test-based reasoning is a general methodology. Methodology means not just an idea, the technology you can add by yourself based on your domain. But this methodology is the flow of how the question they set if we use the test-based reason. Okay. So that is important for building knowledge-based system rather than isolated technical. That is capable of solving only very specified task. Okay. We can find this figure is important for them the case-based reasoning because this figure is his methodology. A new case and some method to retrieve the case and then reuse and then maybe not fully match, we need to revise adapting and then solve the problem. But if you adapting not solve, usually not solve, human need to add some knowledge to the system to solve. And you will add the new knowledge will restore to the test-based system. Okay. This is our topic about the test-based reasoning. Okay, have any question about the test-based reasoning?